It's a time for Beckett from China. So in the jungle of Pandora, there was always something to discuss, simply because there are so freaking many of these bloody things. So I just wanted to talk about the old Pandora's Box Wireless Edition, and is this thing worth buying? I picked this up and it was very cheap, and nowadays you can find a lot of different old cheap Pandora's boxes simply because they're old, there are so many of them, and people are just basically done with them because they want to have the new one. But there are a lot of problems with wireless versions, and in this video we're going to do an unboxing of both joysticks. We're going to do more like a comparison also with the new version, what are the differences and what are the capabilities when it comes for upgrading. Because there are some things that you really need to know when it comes to wireless Pandora's boxes. It looks a little bit of a basic box, but there are some things inside this Mii machine that are quite interesting and the reason why I bought it. So inside the box, both of them, we're going to get two boxes simply because they're selling this like a single player plug and play wireless, or we're going to buy that like a set, so we're going to get two boxes. So this was a two player version. If you're interested in the Pandora wireless, I always recommend get yourself the two player version, because yeah, finding a second stick is a little bit problematic if you're looking on AliExpress or eBay or whatsoever. Inside the box we're going to get, yeah, a little bit troubling opening it up, but what you're going to get with these wireless versions are the rubber suction knobs that are going to the bottom. We are going to get an extra button for replacing if something is get broken. We're having a power supply. Yeah, this is a UK version. Yeah, it's just a basic 5-volt, but it doesn't matter, it's just a basic 5-volt phone charger, because these versions, the wireless joysticks, have an internal battery that we're going to take a closer look later, because we're going to do a teardown. Here we're going to get all the necessary cables, like USB cables, HDMI cables, you name it, everything that comes normally within Pandora box. And here we're having the joystick itself. And there are some different versions out there. If you're looking on AliExpress, there are quite some different, like transparent version, King of Fighters, Street Fighter, quite a few different versions. If you're going to buy a single version, then this is what you're going to get. One box, Pandora's box, a joystick, and the necessary cabling. Okay, but let's do a little bit of an overview of the cables, what kind of cables you're going to get. This is similar with all the Pandora's boxes. So we're having the HDMI cable. This is just a basic, very short, but sometimes you're going to get a very long one. A USB cable, the suction knobs that I already mentioned. So I grab myself the joystick so I can show you how you need to do this. So you need to screw them in over here. All right, and next up, we're having here another cable. This one is for charging the device itself. And of course, we're having the button, and these are just fake Samba clones. I already reviewed the Pandora Box 6 model, and this is a very old version, the Pandora Box 4S. And as you can see over here, I got the same joysticks, but there are some sellers on AliExpress or eBay giving you the option to buy different versions, different colors. So it's quite interesting. The joysticks are quite big, so I think if you want to put them on your lap, it's very comfortable to play. And of course, it's an 8-button layout, but it is not necessary simply because the 8-button layout is not supported with the Pandora box itself. Only if you manage to find the Pandora box DX nowadays, that's the only one. Okay, so let's do a quick side-by-side comparison with the new model, because fun fact, they added a downgrade with the new model. So the blue version is the new version from the Pandora box 6 that I had in the collection. Basically, the shell itself is exactly the same, the joysticks are the same, the button layout, there is nothing changed over here, but the biggest change is also not with the side. As you can see, these things were made for more like a plug and play stick back in the day. But here at the bottom, you can see the main difference. With the blue version, the new version, we're having batteries. So that's really funny that with the newer version, we're going to get the batteries, and with the older version, we're going to get a lithium battery built in. When you're listening to the button sound, you can hear they're exactly the same, and the same goes for the joystick. And they are just feeling like a Samba clone. They're not the best joysticks, but they're okay. But you can always upgrade them if you want to. Okay, so let's open it up and let's remove the four screws over here, and there are a couple in the middle. So I must say, the construction of the joystick is very nice, very thick plastic, and I do like the quality that they are using. And as you can see over here, we're having this hatch that you can open up. So if you want to remove the ball top, or you need to tie them up. Okay, when you're removing the ball over here, you can finally lift up the upper part so we can get into this joystick itself. stay there. Yes. Alright. Let's open it up because I just wanted to show you what's inside. And as you can see, there was a very thick cable. The way how they made this is very basic because there are not a lot of components there. But if you want to swap out the joystick and the buttons, it's very easy to do. So when you take a close look at everything, they're just the basic buttons you're going to get in all Pandora's boxes. The basic Sama clones. But I must say, the way how they made this joystick, it looks really nice. And if let's remove this connector so we can take a close look at the bottom part. When you take a close look at this, you can see that it's just a basic joystick. So if you get going to get yourself a Sama joystick, you can replace it. It's very easy. Plug and play, remove four screws and the cable. But the reason why I want to open it up is very simple. I want to remove these screws and I wanted to see what's beneath the battery pack. Alright, so let's remove the last cover because I'm so curious what's inside. And as you can see over here, it's just a basic battery 1000 milliamp that you can get. There's even room for a big one if you want to give this thing a bigger improvement battery. So nevertheless, this is what you're going to get inside. These things are very cheap to buy on AliExpress or maybe your local electronics store. So this is what you're going to get. I will turn it around so you can see what kind of number it is, what kind of type. It's from 2017. So this thing is a couple of years old. Alright, so the Pandora Box 4 and 5 models are this black box with Pandora Box decal at front and an on and off switch. Yeah, that is something that is with Pandora Box and very deluxe thing because not all the Pandora Box consoles have an on and off switch. Yeah, kind of strange, but it is true. So if you're looking at the back, a fun fact is that the new Pandora Box or the Pandora Game 3D Plus Edition and Normal are exactly the same layout. So take a consideration that only more like the non-Pandora Box versions will fit in this casing. And that is not a bad thing. But the question remains, can you upgrade this Pandora Box? Because if you take a close look at the new version at the right, the white version, it looks, by the way, fantastic. But there are some things you need to take in consideration if you're buying and spending a lot of money on these Pandora's boxes. As you can see here in the back with the new and the old model, you can see there are a lot of differences with the connectors. Because with the new Pandora Box 6 model, you can put in DX in it or Pandora Box 9, but you can't put in Pandora Key 7 or in Pandora or Pandora Game 3D in it. And the biggest problem I'm having with these non-upgradable Pandora's boxes, that you're stuck with the game. So if the main board really sucks, you're just done with upgrading. There are sometimes a company who gives you a decent board or a decent upgrade, but most of the time you're just stuck with it. So when opening up, there was one thing that I noticed. The receiver is using the EDA connector. So for the people not familiar with Pandora Box, the EDA connector here at the left side, you can see that this is completely something new. This device, this PCB board, you can basically just pull it out. And what is very convenient, and I tried it before making this video, if you pull this thing out, you grab yourself a different mainboard, you put it in here, you can basically use the EDA connector on your new mainboard and you have a possibility to upgrade. So let's take a close look at the other version, the Pandora Box number 6, and there's also the Pandora Box 9 and DX. I really love the LEDs in this thing, it looks amazing, but let's remove the mainboard. The way how it's assembled is slightly different. So keep in mind, this is the Pandora Box number 6. So this thing is quite new, no, still even 2020 making this video. Okay, let's remove the cable for the lighter feature. And this is for the on and off switch. As you can see, the on and off switch is completely different. It's at the backside. But there are quite some different things here on this mainboard, and that makes this less interesting to buy. But if you take in consideration that you don't have this IDA connector, no, because they are soldering the receiver on the mainboard. And this is just a big bummer. There is no way for upgrading. So if you just slap a new mainboard and you don't have a receiver, you can't use your wireless controllers. So you need to take consideration. The Pandora Box has this, and I'm guessing the DX has this too. So that is just a big bummer. So if you upgrade the old Pandora Box 4 that having here at the left side in the black box, it's very easy to do. Just plug and play. I tried it with the Pandora Game 3D, but with the Pandora Box 6, this is going to be a problem in the future. Okay, so let's boot it up, and I must say that the lighter feature of this thing is pretty awesome, even for an old model. And let's see how is the menu of the old school Pandora Box. So like all the previous models, we're going to get this intro music. I must say with this old model, the 4S, this intro is quite interesting. Alright, so the Pandora Box 4 Special. This is the menu what you're going to get. I have seen this many times before with different models like the Pandora Key, the fake versions, let's put it this way. But when you're having the Pandora Box 4S, it doesn't have a lot of games included. And all the games are basically Neo Geo or MAME based. There's no PlayStation 1 whatsoever because it's just from, let's say, the latest year, they're having the option to play those games. So when it comes to the game list, it's pretty tiny compared with all the versions. 680 games, and I can tell you there are quite some different double games, Duo of Regents. So with the menu, it's the same story, pretty basic. We have an EO testing, credit settings, exit game mode, auto exit, select game mode, quality optimization, and some game settings. And that's it. And no aspect ratio changing. Okay, so let's start with Blood Bros, one of my favorite shooter games, but you can hear with the music, it's not like it should be. The music is super slow, the sound effects are here, and the gameplay itself, it's pretty smooth, but the sound is just horrible due to using not the right emulator or something like that. This is a common problem with all the Pandora boxes so far, I know. Alright, so next up, let's try a little bit of Metal Slug, but we're going to use the quality optimization. There's something you hate or you like it, but everything looks a little bit more smoother this way. I find it very fascinating seeing the CPS3 system running very well on this Pandora's box. So for the shmup that needs an upright cabinet, sadly we don't have the option to rotate the display or to rotate the screen itself in the software, so what we're going to get are the two black bars. But it's better than going to get a stretched shmup game. I have seen it before and I'm happy they didn't do this. So in short, is it still worth picking up a very old Pandora box? Depends what kind of model it is. If you're having a wireless version like this and you want to upgrade it, yep, it's pretty awesome and you can upgrade it with the Pandora game 3D. So there's quite some options out there. And I think it's an even better deal because if you're going to get the newer Pandora box, you're just stuck with the main board that's inside. And good luck finding a Pandora box including a wireless receiver. So this is what you're going to get. The joystick, there are some minor downgrades in my opinion with the battery life. I think it's still a great set. I really love it to play on the couch with two wireless sticks, play some old school games. Yeah, well, thank you for watching. Consider subscribing, hit the little bell, become one of the Wicked family, and it would be great to see you in the next video.